Hi, my name's Ashton Gaskill, the author of the 12 Dozen Kingdoms series. Today, I'll be taking part in a YouTube AuthorTube collaboration project called Writers Busting Writing Myths. We have 12 writers busting 12 myths over the course of 12 weeks. Every Wednesday, you can check in and see what we have for you. Links to all the other channels are in the description, so be sure to check them out. Today, I'll be talking about the myth that there's a foolproof method to writing a great book. At first, that might seem a little strange. I don't know that I've ever heard someone put it into exactly those words, but I have gotten the implication from a lot of people who give writing advice on the internet. This implication comes from two different directions. The first of which is the advice to just write. Oftentimes, when people go to various writing communities, they ask, what's the best way to go about things? Where is the best place to start? They're new to this writing thing. They want to be a writer. They have ideas. They have dreams and hopes. But they're unsure about the best way to achieve those, especially the best way to achieve those in a timely fashion. And so, with good intentions, many writers who've been through the process, who've been there, they've been new writers, they've learned some things. They tell these blossoming newcomers to just write, to not overthink it, to not worry about anything else, just to sit down, butt in the chair, fingers on the keyboard, just write. And while that is good advice, it's advice that's helpful to a lot of people, it isn't advice that works for everybody all the time. Oftentimes, especially for new writers, sitting down to write and looking at that blank page is too imposing. It leads to what they consider to be writing blocks. It leads to a lack of creativity. It leads to decision paralysis, where anything could happen, so they don't know what should happen. And boiling that all down to just telling them to just go write doesn't really provide them with any helpful guidance, which leads us to the second way that the idea of an easy way of writing comes in, and that's through outlining. So you have the people who write by the seat of their pants, who discovery write their way through the book, saying to just write. And on the opposite end of the spectrum, we have people who use plotting methods, who outline, whether it's a very loose outline or a very thorough outline, saying the best way to proceed is to outline everything, make sure the plot works, and then go from there. Organizing your ideas and thoughts like this often does help to get rid of those writer's blocks. It can help you to get over those obstructions in your writing process. And while I personally believe that it can lead to a better book, in and of itself, outlining isn't going to lead to quality. Writing a book always takes some dedication, but writing just any 50,000 words is relatively easy. It's writing a good book that's difficult. And the advice to just write or to focus on an outline first, neither of those really hit that spot. And even once the book is written, there are plenty of other pitfalls that are difficult to navigate for a first-time writer. It's never as simple as a quick bit of advice can cover. In editing, there are lots of places you can trip. There are lots of things you need to look out for. There's as many different things you need to keep in mind as there are aspects of your book. For a book to be great, it has to be great in every aspect. And keeping track of all those aspects can be really difficult, no matter how quippy of a little catchphrase or a list of top 10 ways can sound. Personally, I know that spending time meticulously outlining a novel, then just writing it, and then editing it based on common advice, those little quips that we hear so often, it doesn't work. I know that because I tried. I found an outlining method that seemed really easy. It seemed like it practically guaranteed you to have a good book, to have a good story at the very least, if not necessarily a great one. So I sat down and I followed those outlining steps, and I outlined something that I thought looked really good. I was really excited to get into it, so when I started writing it, sitting down, butt in seat, fingers on keyboard, wasn't difficult, and I could just write my way through. And I figured, just focus on the writing. I know the plot's already decent. And then I can edit away any mistakes easily enough by following this common editing advice. So I got through, and I used a program that tracked a lot of those common editing advices. It provided me with spots where my prose was too complicated. It showed me which words to avoid using or which turns of phrase were cliches. And I just followed every single thing it suggested blindly. So I outlined the way I was supposed to outline. I just sat down and wrote it the way that I was supposed to just write it. And then I followed all the advice on how I was supposed to edit it. And then I put it all together. I was super proud. And I put it out into the world for some other people to read. And immediately, they all basically said it was unreadable. My prose was super choppy. It was way too simple, and my sentences were just too short. It was very repetitive, because there wasn't any change in the cadence. It was overly direct, and very hard for other people to get into. It was hard for me to get into, in some respects. Writing is hard. However, it's also very rewarding. I hope that you can learn from my mistakes and take writing advice with a grain of salt. There is no foolproof path to excellent writing. Be honest with yourself about the quality of your writing. Keep editing and rewriting even when it's the last thing you want to do. And be patient as your skill grows. Thank you for watching and listening to me. Remember to check out the other channels down in the description. And I hope you all have a great day.